you'll never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy. We must be cautious.
The future is Favreau. Welcome back to the Cantina, Smugglers and Scoundrels. This is Stephanie, your Chaos Coordinator, Wookiee Wrangler. And remember, you know all the rules. No Raylos, no Disney canon fans, no ST fans, no Kennedy sycophants, butt kissers, bootlickers of any kind. The Wookiee bouncers and the Diveronians will throw your ass out. Today I want to talk a little bit about what a lot of other people are talking about. And I'm going to add a little bit of Doomcock stuff to this and a little bit of my own theorizing, so get ready. So Deadline Hollywood and a bunch of other, entertainment rags talked to Jon Favreau interview about The Mandalorian and about Star Wars. And it's very interesting to me. Very interesting. Because he's basically sounding like the voice of Lucasfilm now. And why is it interesting? Well, like I said, he's sounding like he's the voice of Lucasfilm. Let's talk a little bit about Jon Favreau, where he came from, and his connection to the franchise, which is generational like the rest of us. Jon Favreau is Generation X. He was born in 1966 in Queens, New York, of a Russian Jewish mother and a French Italian dad. He went to Queens College, worked for a little bit at Bear Stearns. I got all this from Wikipedia, by the way. Ended up going to Chicago to take part in improv theater, work on comedy, and then he moved to Los Angeles, and the first time I ever remember seeing this guy is he directed it, but he wrote the movie Swingers about guys surviving in L.A. as a comedian with a bunch of his guy friends. It's sort of a guy's movie point of view thing, and Vince Vaughn was in it. A very good movie. I really enjoyed that movie. But he's been around doing a lot of different things in Hollywood for a long time. And he directed the movie Iron Man, which is the only Marvel movie I've ever liked. He is good friends with people like Vince Vaughn, Luke Wilson. There's a generation of actors and directors in Hollywood that were inspired by George Lucas and Steven Spielberg, that are Generation X, that came to do good things. And their voices are now finally being heard. Jon Favreau is one of them. Favreau is an OG fan. He is an old school fan. And I think part of the problem that he had, I think, with the way the franchise has been going, is the same problem the rest of us have had, including younger fans, too, that fell in love with the original trilogy and the prequels. There's something really wrong with the vision Kathy Kennedy has of the franchise. And it looks to me, I don't know the whole story, but he developed The Mandalorian with, it looks like, Dave Filoni, and they made it. It's really the only thing that has united the fan base. And when you look at the interviews with him, he basically said, you cannot forget the old fans. You can't forget where this franchise came from, and we have to reach out to them. And with The Mandalorian, they have reached out to us, and they made a show that even these, the few new fans, this new fan base that they were desperate, and I mean desperate to develop, that never really materialized, they even they liked it. So what is this future? Is Favreau? Well, to me, it looks like, because of these interviews, because of the success that he has made with The Mandalorian, the 15 Emmy nominations, the buzz, the fact that it's I think the most successful show on Disney Plus. He is going to be, I think from here on out, the guiding hand of the Star Wars franchise. And, you know, when we talk about The Mandalorian, there's a lot of George Lucas there. And Favreau said he's a DJ replaying the Beatles. The Mandalorian is it's a very stark, desolate show. But when you get right down to it, when you watch the original trilogy, so much of the original trilogy takes place in desolate places. Tatooine. Hoth. Dagobah, teeming with life, but desolate. There's no civilization. There's nothing that a human being would recognize as being familiar to them, to him. And The Mandalorian is a show based on the Old West. Favreau has experience doing Westerns with Cowboys and Aliens, which I liked, which was a good show. And I don't care if you didn't like it or not, I liked it. And The Mandalorian shows that he does have a depth of talent with that kind of genre. Favreau is a multi-talented guy. Favreau is a guy that really understands what the fans want. I didn't feel like when I was watching The Mandalorian that I was being consumed by social justice bullshit. I wasn't, you know, I didn't have someone's, you know, sexuality shoved down my throat. I didn't have uncouth, uncivilized messages that are anti everything that I stand for, that I think most normal human beings stand for, shoved in our face, in my face. The Mandalorian was there strictly to entertain and bring back that feeling that of what Star Wars is. You are hanging on the edge of a known universe. This is a place where people who don't necessarily flow through the regular kind of confines of society live. The outlaw, the criminal, the bounty hunter, the organized crime lord, that kind of thing. It is an Old West, Western film, kind of like how Tatooine was, and Han Solo's world was in the original trilogy when we first meet him. And that, to me, says a lot about what Favreau wants to do with Star Wars itself. Expand the stories, but don't forget where you came from and remember everything George Lucas created. And instead of trying to change it, which is what Kennedy, Hidalgo, and the rest of these cultural barbarians and Taliban did, talk about it. Celebrate it. Star Wars can teach kids a lot of things about how to be a hero. Little boys deserve their heroes. And I think Jon Favreau would agree with me on that. Here he is with George Lucas. Again, he is learning at the feet of the master. Now let's talk a little bit about Ichibaka's rumors that Lucas is back. I do think George is back. I really, really do. Too many people are now talking about it. It's been out there for months that he has been quietly helping with everything with The Mandalorian. He did have a lot to do with The Rise of Skywalker. That stuff was completely changed. Even Pablo Hidalgo admitted it in a tweet that was found on Reddit. Kennedy hated what they did, because her vision is anti-ethical and to everything George Lucas stands for. But then Kathleen Kennedy doesn't understand Star Wars, doesn't want to know anything about it, and in fact hates everything George Lucas did. When Favreau says that, yes, he did come up with Baby Yoda, I agree with that. But that character, to me, I mean, look at him. He screams, little shit. He screams George Lucas to me. And that, if Lucas quietly said something about, why don't we make the child Baby Yoda? It is everything that Star Wars is about. Give the people something new, but recall the past. This is what the child is. And Favreau hates it when we call him Baby Yoda. But since we don't know what Yoda's species is, and that's the mystery, and I hope he remains a mystery forever, that's everything. The child is everything that Lucas would have thought to create for this show. And Favreau and Filoni ran with it, and here they are together. The Mandalorian is basically what Star Wars is. Everybody, of course, is worried about it getting screwed up, la la la, but considering the major players came back, Favreau, Filoni, George Lucas helped write the scripts. It's going to be premiering in October. We'll see what happens. I mean, I am going to give Disney the benefit of a doubt if they can keep this up. And if they're smart, they will. And Bob Chapek, basically said in not so many words that this is what he wants to do. Now, what does this have to do with Lucas? Well, Favreau, if you look at his Wikipedia, he's producing a lot of other things. He's also developing Lion King 2, the live version of Lion King 2, which, John, I love you, but your talent is being wasted on that, okay? Come on, you know, you're Generation X, and we know the answers to everything, and we do. Entertain us, make us happy. And that's what I think he set out to do, but he's also got a lot of other things on his agenda, and I think running Lucasfilm in the way that it needs to be run is going to be a full-time job. So my thing is this. I think that George Lucas is probably coming in as an interim until Favreau can devote his full-time attention on Lucasfilm. I do think that the announcement for the big announcement for Lucasfilm is coming in September will be something like that. I think they're going to announce Kathy Kennedy resigns early. Kathy Kennedy is better suited to her message movies, and I think that's what she should be doing. She's better suited to making some sort of mockumentary of the traditional family for Netflix or some other streaming service, and making movies with her husband. And I think that's where she's going to be. And I really think that Favreau is the future of Star Wars, and Lucas is going to be there to guide him and help him. And that's as it should. And I do believe until Favreau's ready, until he's got the time to do it, that George Lucas is probably going to be leading Lucasfilm in the interim. And I also believe that there's going to be a lot of changes at Lucasfilm as far as personnel. Watch for the layoffs. This week, I think they're probably going to be doing their divisional earning statements from each division. And Lucasfilm probably earned a nickel, all right, with their garbage. They pushed everything back that they were going to have out And I honestly am wondering just how much of it's going to be seen. The Project Luminous is just ridiculous. And I think Disney knows that. And Chapek is a numbers guy, if we remember, as Neon at Clownfish TV says. And to be honest, I really kind of just watch now to see the next moves. Disney, of course, can't go on doing what they're doing. And we've talked about that. I talked about that on my live stream yesterday. And it's basically, this is what's going to happen. And there's going to be a lot of angry SJWs. But you got to remember, the whining, bitching, and complaining on Twitter is not real life. Twitter has the smallest footprint in social media as far as the big three by far. And I think after this election, to be honest, I don't think Twitter's going to last long. Now, they were bragging that they've got so many new members, but we'll see what happens. And again, just because you're an SJW doesn't mean you're a majority of people. In fact, the majority of people hate those people, all right? We have a very small minority of people who want to change society, to change life, because they're upset with something or their personal issues. And those issues projected themselves into movies, books, music, and everything else. And you can't really be an artist if all you do is project your political leanings everywhere. That's not how you art. I've talked about that before. I'm not going to talk about it. Favreau is an old school 1977 Star Wars fan. And it's funny. The OG fans span all politics, all races, all creeds, all faiths, and they're going to be heard. And, you know, Neon and Geeky Sparkles were talking about digital acting, actors. And, you know, if they're going to project that into Star Wars, they're changing the message. And that's one of the reasons why we couldn't stand it. Now, I'm going to admit, I'm not a fan of Ahsoka Tano. I don't get it. I don't get her. But she's Dave Filoni's baby. She's his Luke Skywalker. So we're going to see Ahsoka. We're going to see a TV show with her. And as we talked about, as I started out talking here, about digitally created Luke Skywalker, digitally created Han Solo, Carrie Fisher's family, definitely would allow that for Carrie. So, because they allowed it for The Rise of Skywalker. So we'll see. And I think it actually, the future being Favreau, I think it actually works out really, really well. I couldn't, in fact, think of anybody else except for maybe somebody in The Phantom Menace who could unite the fans more than somebody like Favreau, because he is one of us. He is Phantom Menace. He is just like George Lucas is. I'm not sure if Dave Filoni is. He said some things that were off. But I also, when you also remember at the time, Kathy Kennedy was at the apex of her power. And what was he going to do? You have to kiss the boss's ring. So he was doing that. And because let me tell you this, if he goes, Star Wars was really screwed. So anyway, the future is Favreau and George Lucas and Filoni together. This is Steph signing off. I'll see you around the galaxy. We'll be right back.